okay, not candy bar. Okay, if you look in the journals and you talk to other people, they've got all sorts of recipes for candy board. Mix the sugar and the water and some other type of tartar sauce and all sorts of stuff. That's not necessary. This is really the simplest thing. What you have to remember is how to count the five. One, two, three, four, five. 1 cup of water, 5 pounds of sugar, and you heat it to 234 degrees. And pour it into a mold. Okay, now, all sorts of things you can use for a mold. Here is Baker's cookie container, which makes wonderful molds. If I remember, this will take a 5 pound of sugar. So if you use this candy board with 5 pounds of sugar, I think both of these will be filled up. That's really nice. After it hardens, you just put it on top of the frames. These will take it down for starter. I use this a lot because I drink a lot of half-gallon containers of milk. I make this little thing here because this will swell a little bit. This will hold 5 pounds of sugar, just exactly 5 pounds of sugar. Just take one of these here, cut it out, and when you pour the sugar syrup in there, it'll kind of bulge out like that. So I need a little box here to keep it intact. This I find really nice because it takes you, maybe 10, 15 minutes to make it. You can come to a colony, especially when you start getting into February, and it's low on, you stick this right on top of the cluster, and they'll take that sugar syrup down and keep it from starting. You can throw this in the back of your car, you don't have to worry about spilling anything. It keeps forever.
So they climb in the top on that.
You put the hole facing down on the cluster, they'll go right up there and they'll take all that down.
You can put that on top of an empty super, on top of your...
Puts it on the top bars. Of course, you need a super above it to protect it from the elements. And so you're looking, you're in trouble when you go to your bees. Say your bees are going into the winter and you fed them and everything is heavy so that you know that the bees are going to last you until February. You go in February and you notice the bees coming up the top. You're in trouble when you start seeing the bees coming up to the top. As long as you see the bees way down below or you don't see them, you're okay. When you start seeing the bees come up to the top, then put one of these on top.
Are they coming to the top because they've eaten up?
That's right. They're eating all the way up to the top. Now there may be honey off to the side. If it's cold, they won't go over to the side. They'll starve to death. They come to the top, and so you put that on top to keep them from starving. And they'll take that other honey later on in March and April when it gets warmer. But if it's February, they can come out at the top, and that stuff over there, lots of honey, they'll start that. And so these are really nice too. I mean, they're just the Baker cookie thing. And just put it on top like that. Now, in the magazines, they'll show you to take an inner cover, seal up the hole, pour in 10, 15 pounds of the sugar board. Well, that is nice because you got a lot of sugar for them. But the problem sometimes is the bees coming up the center will eat all that sugar board in the center, and then it's real cold, all the sugar board off to the side, they'll starve to death. Whereas you can throw one of these things on top, see, and they've got quite a distance to go. And so I really prefer this. If you use the inner cover, you're talking about 15, 20 pounds of sugar, but it has these drawbacks that I just referred to. So I really prefer this. You can use a gallon, of course. A gallon you can use the same way. But I really like it this way.
Well, the viscosity of that in there is very, it's almost a solid.
It's a solid. Oh, yeah, it's rock. It's like rock. But you want to pour it as soon as you hit 234 degrees, take it off the stove. Don't let it stand and say, well, I'll come back in half an hour and pour it. By the way, it hardens up very fast.
That's 2 to 1 you're talking about.
No. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, look at
it. 2 to 1 is the syrup.
Okay.
So the temperature won't melt those things?
No, I use both of these repeatedly, okay. But the temperature will melt. Some things they'll melt. If styrofoam, some styrofoam will melt. So you don't use styrofoam. it'll sometimes, although I've used styrofoam cups, and I've had success with those. But I do know some styrofoam will melt, so you gotta be careful. So, you know, so simple. All you have to do, they would be able to channel your five fingers. You don't have to worry about other components going, other ingredients going, and that sort of thing.
Why do people put other stuff in?
I'm sorry?
Why do people put other stuff in the
I don't know. I don't even know.
Wait, there's how many different beekeepers are there? There's different ideas.
Oh, yeah. One thing, you talk to five beekeepers, you'll get seven different opinions. I mean, beekeepers all have their own. They're pretty opinionated, too, sometimes.
I have another question, just very quickly, going back to the discussion about the terramycin. In here it says, do not use shortening that contains animal fat.
Yeah, what you want to use is Crisco.
Yeah, why not?
I think some of that turns rancid.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
And so, you know, Crisco vegetable shortening, the solid stuff, or the semi-solid stuff, what you want to use.
Mix it with your hands.
I mean, that's the way I mix it. I mix it. Put the terramycin in and just treat it like dough, mix it with your hands, and